Hi, my name is Denise Julia. So, to make it fun, we're gonna do a randomizer called the Baddie Bot, where all of my makeup essentials are gonna be there. So there's like three faces to my makeup routine. You can call him Jonas. Jonas is my hairstylist.
Hello.
What's our look for today? What's the usual Denise?
Yeah, we're gonna do the signature Denise Julia sleek straight hair.
Gano'ng katagal yung hair natin usually?
Well, 30 to 45 minutes lang.
Pero pag curly,
One hour.
1 hour. A lot of them love my curly hair too.
How long does it take for you to get ready?
Probably like 30 to 40 minutes.
But tell us how long it takes for you to wake up.
Takes me like 2 hours to wake up. Like when I tell them, okay, let's do it at 4. No, we're not gonna do it at 4. It's gonna be like 6 p.m., bruh. I'm late to everything. I should change that. Can we add in like a thinking sound there? First step. So we have the Kiehl's Clearly Corrective Dark Spot Solution. And then my sunscreen. BLK Sheer Sunscreen Primer Sticker. I know it's nighttime right now, but I'm showing you guys my daily makeup, normal makeup routine, and I always use sunscreen.
But not a lot of people know this. I think your fans know this, but she has a very good sense of humor.
True.
Very quick-witted.
Carissa dies laughing all the time. She dies. Like, I kid you not, like, dies. So, for concealer, I use the Huda Beauty in shade Cookie Dough. This is the best concealer that I've ever tried. I kid you not. It's so underrated. And it's not a Denise Julia makeup if you don't use your fingers to blend. I always use my fingers to blend. Oh, I'm an oily girl. Super oily. I saw someone say that I look like an oily fish. You're not lying. Hater. I know people think I'm like the type to be like, what the fuck? But I actually listen to a lot of criticism and try to change them, like improve myself in areas that I can.
Contour powder.
Next is the NARS concealer. I use two shades. I use medium 2 and medium slash deep 1.5. So it depends on the area that I want to use it on. For example, if it's in this area, I use the deeper shade because I'm deeper at the sides. I gotta grab my purple. It just adds like more coverage. Next is the key to sculpting, I feel like, is a good creamy bronzer. I use the Rare Beauty in the shade Good Energy. This is the holy grail for me. This is probably the creamiest bronzer that I've tried so far. You can see it's almost gone. This is how you shape your face. I put a lot on my forehead because when you're performing and there's like a lot of lights, you have to be tanner, more bronze than usual so that it balances the lights. It's like all over your face. Where your shadow naturally hits, like for example, you're looking in front and then where the shadow hits, like that's where you should put your contour. For me at least. And then, super duper insecure ako about my jawline. So I contour the fuck out of this shit. I'm gonna sneeze. You have to look at the light to sneeze. Yan, tingnan nyo. Ganyan ako lala, mag-contour ng jawline. Kasi wala akong jawline. And then, for my nose, I do a little button moment. I got my nose done last year, September or October, according to my bestie. She was there when I was recovering, and she saw the hell that I went through when I was recovering. I got my tip done, what's called tipplasty. So I don't have a implant. It's just a tip. It's just the tip. Dom, shout out to you. Just a tip. I also got my lips done at the same time, but I had them removed already, I think, middle of this year?
Like, dissolved completely.
Yeah. The first makeup product that I ever used was probably a lip gloss. You like to change ng color, tapos nasa roller siya. Yung mga tig 50 pesos lang ata before nun sa Divisoria. Magic lip gloss. Next, we are gonna bake with this dirty ass blender. So I used the Laura Mercier translucent honey. A little dot here. I don't bake for long. As soon as I press it in, I brush it off immediately because I figure that it gets cakey when you leave it too long. Yeah. Next step would be our bronzer. So I use the Patrick Ta in the shade She Sculpted. So I look at this as like the setting powder for your contour. My jawline, because I hate my jawline. I need a jawline. Next would be our contour powder. Sunny's Face. It's in the shade Cacao. It's the perfect contour shade for me, at least, for my skin tone. Then the nose. It looks heavy, but we're gonna trust the process. So for me, I use cool toned blushes like this one. It's in the shade Mocha Matte, their powder blush, and I put it on top of my contour area. So like when I smile, that's where I would put it. I used to hate blush, by the way. I used to never put blush on. Because I've never found a blush that worked well for my skin tone before.
That's so true.
Right? When you're Morena, red. You look red. Because like the blushes before would be either super red or for lighter skin tone. So I would look like a chalkboard when I would put blush on. This is how I look like with blush. For our next step, it's the highlight. So I use 3 different highlighters. Number one would be the Hourglass Ambient Lighting. So I use the Hourglass highlighter to just set the mood before actually putting on the highlighter. So you'd put it everywhere that you're gonna add the actual highlighter. I look different in this camera. Next would be the middle base. Fuck, I'm just making shit up. This is called the Hyper Real Glow. From MAC Cosmetics. As you can see, it's so used. Gold in the pinky shade, and I use my fingers to put it on so that it's more pigmented. Put on my brows.
You can never have too much highlight.
True! And then, my most favorite highlighter of all time, the MAC X Lisa This just gives like that pinky purple duochrome moment, I feel like. I pack that on, like back. So this is the base. So now we are on to phase two. We are gonna focus on the eyes. I just use my bronzer as eyeshadow. So that's the base shadow that I use. And then for the palette, I use the Soft Glam ABH Anastasia Beverly Hills palette, which is utterly destroyed. We're gonna use the shade Dusty Rose. This is such a good mauve-y shade. And we're gonna pack that on our lids.
Go. I have a personal question for you. I think you're, from ground up, self-made artist.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think you would call yourself that as well? Because artists make me do art.
Mm-hmm. A self-made artist for sure. That's the part that I'm gonna be super proud of. I started posting covers on TikTok, on Twitter and TikTok, and then shit just went viral. So you know, it happened in a pace that I wasn't ready for, actually. So I feel like it's natural for people to say na kunwari ang bilis niyang nag-boom ganyan. Syempre madaming mga assumptions about that na parang you're an industry plant or like you're a nepo baby, you have a powerful entity behind you, when really it's the fans and the listeners that made it that way. I'm using Cypress Umber and Rustic on my lid, like a little liner moment. There we go. This is one of my favorite parts when I'm doing the eyes. It's the inner corner highlight and the brow bone highlight. Because depending on what I'm wearing for that performance or that day, the color changes. I bought this recently. It's the Cosmos ABH palette. And the shades are so pretty. Oh my god, I forget how good this palette is. It's so purple. I use the shade Supernova. And then I'm gonna use this shade Sun and Orion to like layer that, because I like layering my inner corner. Is this still on? I'm like scared if it's not on anymore.
Do you think in the future you would have your own makeup line?
I've thought about this a lot. I wanted to open a lip gloss line before, a lash line, whatever. But the makeup industry is just so crowded right now, and I don't want to add to the carbon footprint of the earth from producing so much more stuff that I feel like is not needed. Maybe it would be like a one-time thing, you know, like an exclusive type of maybe limited edition, whatever. But I want to focus more on a different aspect. I don't want to say it yet, but it's gonna happen in the future. Not makeup. It will be a different part of like the industry. I'm open to it, but personally at this moment I'm not. I just don't want to put more waste onto the earth. So I use the sun for my brow bone, and then I'm gonna add Supernova in my lower lash line. The eyes as of the moment. The brows is the next step. I use a dried up mascara for the brows. So this is like one of my dried up mascaras.
What is your favorite part about singing? Is it your producing, mm-hmm. writing, or writing?
So my favorite part is essentially thinking of what a song will be. For example, with Lakin, I dreamt about that melody, like the piano was playing in my mind on and on and on. So my favorite part was when I got up, I recorded that piano melody in my phone, and then I wrote over it. I don't talk a lot about my feelings, so I use music to kind of like express that. I look so funny right now, but this is the brows.
Funny.
Oh wait, I do use a brow product, but it's just to fill in the sparse, like the bald spots. Strokes Beauty, the Microblade Pen Perfector. One of the most requested tutorial are my lashes. You can see my eyes right now. They're not foxy. The secret is through the lashes. This is a fresh lash from Paulash in the style Aries. This is the only lash that I use. I stand by this style of lashes. It's the best. So this is what I do. I get the back of, when I perform, I always have glue in my hands because I put the lash here and then I apply lash glue on my hands. Every time I go out or I perform, best believe I have glue on my hands. I have a theory that my lashes are alive.
They're crawling.
They have life.
Everyone who's been around me has had an experience with my lashes. It's stuck on their phone or stuck on their arm or stuck on their brush. My lashes get stuck
in my hair.
Stuck in her hair. She woke up, brushed her hair, and my lash came out of her hair.
I went home and I removed my shoe and I was like, oh my gosh, there's a bug on my shoe. It was her lash. It was literally her lash.
Oh wait, let me show them the key first to applying lashes. This is important. I put it under my lashes. So you put it under, press it, and then the outer side, you lift it like higher than your normal lash line. Like that, you stick it up. See the difference between the side with the lashes on and, yeah, that's the difference. And if I move closer, you can see na nakaangat talaga siya. Like it's higher than my normal lash line. Then we're gonna do the same thing for the other eye. But shout out to Miss Kim, my lash tech. Whenever I feel like getting extensions, I only get it done at the Lush Room by Kim, Miss Kim. You can ask her for my style because she customizes my own lashes.
Food.
Oh, food. Yeah. Wait, look at my lashes.
It changed
everything.
Our whole team.
This is my team.
So much weight just by hanging around her and from eating.
Yes. Trust me, I gained weight in a good way because she made me love food. Like, I feed people. That's her love language.
My love language. Yeah. I like the look on their faces when they like what they're eating. I like cooking for the people I love.
Oh my god. Anyway, I want to go details about the creamy garlic beef that I love.
Anyway, this is my eyes. Last phase. The final phase. I take a lot of pride in the way that I do my lips because it's a signature. People got lip fillers in the name of Denise Julia. Literally. Number one, it's a good lip liner. I use a contour stick actually as my lip liner because I feel like I can't find the perfect brown shade to line my lips. I'm not saying that you should get this lip liner or this product specifically, but at least get a shade that's close to it. So this is the BLK stick in Cookie. You can see where like the white area is, like the edge of my lips. That's where I would put my lip liner. Wait, look at that. Looking like a Bratz doll. I add a lighter lip liner on top because this is really dark, as you can see. I use the BLK. I forgot the shade, but it's this shade. Well, I can talk about Sugar and Spice. I feel like I always say this to my best friend, but the type of love that a girl can give really cannot compare to, I feel like, okay, what a guy can give. It's just so deep. It doesn't even have to be romantic. It doesn't have to be sexual. It can be something as, you know, deep as your friendships with girls, like me to my best friend. When I was writing songs, it was best to capture or like tell the story of a girl falling for a girl in a beautiful light, because that's how I see it. Versus men, because men are just an entire different species. This is what I use to create an ombre, like a lighter medium lip liner. And then I use the Huda Beauty. Sometimes I don't put lipstick anymore on the center, but for the days that I do, I use this lipstick in the shade Girl's Trip. You can find like a shade that's near to this color, but it's like a light pink nude, and I'll just dab it. I don't swipe it. There. Voila. And for a final step on the lips, a good lip gloss. Which one, kaya? This one?
Oh, which one?
I have a lot.
Yeah, when we pack her bag, her purse for shows, usually there's at least six
lip glosses. A lot of glosses. I can show you my favorites. A lot. So I just recently got this YSL gloss. It's so good. It's like my lips but better. Oh, NARS. Sorry. In the shade Unbroken. So this one I use for shows. In the shade Glow by Smashbox. And then the Fenty Beauty. This was my everyday gloss before. It's in the shade Fussy. And then for my top two as of the moment, the Dior Lip Glow Oil in the clear shade. Obviously, it's like tinted now because I use it so often. And the Dior Maximizer. For today, we're gonna use this. Oof. Yummy. I'm gonna zoom in. Ooh. Actually, I wanna show them how it looks like with a performance gloss. This one. This is just so pretty. I'm gonna put it on so you guys can see it. See that? It's so shiny and pretty. Oh, final step. Setting spray. Anastasia Dewy Setting Spray. So that it's glowy on stage or even just for everyday makeup. Can see the highlight, the lip liner, the eyes, the lashes, the hair, everything. This is how it looks like. Speaking from play to play, you might